By train. From Loomis Station, the track ran straight for several miles, with straggly town on one side. Arlap's Grocery, where you could buy Chinese ginger and jars, the Scout Hall, the Anglican Church, the Jam Factory, and vineyards and farms on the other. Then the line began to curve, and the impression one had was of worming into Auckland. It went up inclines and through cuttings, and you saw a grey fringe of cemetery overlapping the hill and the lumpy end of the ranges on the other side. Once across the spindly bridge, there was no creeping. You stabbed like a knife. Avondale, Mount Albert. Houses tumbling one against the other, iron roofs and a frayed quilt of reds and green, and Morningside, Kingsland, with Eden Park mown like a lawn waiting for the big match Saturday, then the prison, an English castle with a quarry where the prisoners broke stones. An Auckland Grammar standing above its Kublai Khan buildings in the sun, and boys in navy blue kicking footballs high. What happened when a football went into the quarry? Newmarket Tunnel, men cigarettes in the dark and kids making ghost yells, and the smell of sulphur. And once in there, the big kids said a set in tech boy rooted to Sheila, and both had their pants pulled up and were sitting as though nothing had happened by the time the train came out the other end. At Auckland Station, the ramps made you run, and the echoing big hall threatened you, and you felt you might travel up or down instead of along by slanting, sliding ways or by the plucking of a hand, and hear a big, final voice. The dusty, straggling walk along to Queen Street ended that.